Ah, really? Vinyl Community, is there anything better than this? I think not.
Oh yeah, baby. You know what time it is. Friday cheers. There's Peter and Belinda up there with the Maxell guy. Everybody's having a good Friday afternoon. Here's Colton. Here, Colton, but yeah. Cheers, Colton. All right. Set this down. Shut this down too. All right, so you can hear me. Hear my lovely voice on this Friday. Cheers. We are over here. So as you can see, it's almost 5 o'clock in the afternoon. It's pitch black and it's gonna rain. So this is good for what I got going on today. I'll get to that fall theme in a little bit. But yeah, so anyway, Vinyl Community people, hello again. So anyway, today I got a couple things going on. Maybe thought I'd show some VCLT that just arrived yesterday. Just a plethora of VCLT these days. So let's just open this up. Looks like it's fragile. So I know who this is from. Let me get this open. My high-end scissors. All right, what do we got in here? All right. Nothing getting broken in there because that's fragile. All right. Mike, sorry for the delay in sending you this. This thing is your mom reached out and asked for it too. But in the end, I told her I already said I'd send it to you. So Steve made a funny comment on the video I did with my mother on her 95th birthday. Just how he thought he ran into her at a mosh pit at a Dead Kennedys concert. She wasn't fooling anybody. Hilarious. So yes, that note off. So it's Jane's Addiction. It looks like the debut, self-titled. Very nice, and it's from this guy. Steve's a cool guy. I'll just mention like something like that, and then it'll show up in the mail. He sent me countless postcards. Here's one from his travels out at Red Rocks in Boulder, Colorado, I think, just outside of Boulder. Place I know it's called Morrison, Colorado. Anyway, so there's Steve Harold right there. There's his channel. I'll leave a link in the description because I'm high tech, so you can find Steve on your own and check out his channel. So thank you again for that, Steve. Extremely thoughtful. All right, move this a little closer. Close-ups. All right. So what do we got? Yeah, we got that VCLT. What else do we got? Oh yeah. Ever heard of this guy? This is Sam St. John, and he wants us to do a fall themed albums thread. So show 5 albums that maybe have fall in the title. He didn't specify that, but maybe or just in general albums that remind you of the fall months, right before you're heading into the dead of winter. And I've mentioned before, I'm a seasonal listener too, Sam. I head into the jazz. Sam said to me in a comment, he likes jazz in the summer, but. We all like what we like, right? But here he is showing. So one thing that Sam said in his, and a dead ringer for me, I've been living in the U.S. now almost 20 years. Canadian Thanksgiving in Canada is different. It's earlier. I just love the America one because it's like a 4-day weekend. There's football and you don't have to buy any gifts. You just eat, drink, and be merry. So The Last Waltz, which was filmed on Thanksgiving Day, I want to say 1976 because it was the last time the band played together. I think it was at the Winterland Ballroom in San Francisco, Bill Graham's venue. So there's the famous Martin Scorsese documentary, a filmmentary, whatever you want to call it, concert film. And he always watches it on Thanksgiving. And that's a tradition I've probably been doing for about 15 years, Sam. So yeah, something else I have in common with the great Sam St. John. So anyway, I'm going to show 5. And again, these are things that, yeah, I kind of think of. When I think of a fall album, I think of these artists. So Traffic, I have all the Traffic stuff. And for whatever reason, I think it's because I watched some BBC documentary about Steve Winwood several years ago. And, you know, it's on his estate in England. And it's like, it looks like it's winter in England. It's dreary. It's raining. It's kind of miserable, kind of like around here. And so I just think of Traffic at that time of year. And there he is on the back eating a piece of fruit. I think that's Steve Winwood. Yes, that's Steve Winwood. So this is a really good one. This is from, I want to say, 1970. Was it Last Exit? Right, right. So some of the songs on this one, of course, the highlight for me is Shanghai Noodle Factory. That's an awesome jam. And Feeling Good's another one, too. So, yeah, Traffic, just a great band and very fall-like to me for whatever reason. All right, Steve Miller Band. This is their fourth album, Brave New World. Not that this is a fall album, but it's a good classic rock album. And there's a song on this one. Where is it here? The song I'm talking about is called Seasons. So, and here's, look who's here. It's Patty. So you think about the change of seasons, or you think about Patty like I do all the time. What's going on?
You're so nice.
Yes, yes.
I just wanted to say hello to everyone because I hadn't made an appearance lately.
Oh.
Well, I guess I did in Guelph, but.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. And for those in America, happy American Thanksgiving.
Right. We were just talking about Thanksgiving, so that's a very good segue, Patty.
And if anyone's in Boston, in the local area, I'm making 2 cheesecakes.
Oh, for the holiday.
Yeah, brownie cookies.
Brownie cookies.
I'll probably make empires, which are for those in...
My friends in England will know, maybe.
I make my homemade empires. You'll know what those are.
Describe an empire.
Well, it's a shortbread cookie with raspberry jam, another shortbread cookie, and then icing on top.
Oh, God. Gaining the weight just thinking about it.
And the oatmeal cookies that you like.
Oh, yeah. Oatmeal chocolate chip.
The ones with the butterscotch. So if anyone's local, you're welcome to come by for baking.
Talking to you, Anthony, up in Wakefield. Maybe I'll reach out to you this weekend. All right.
Anyways, bye, everybody.
Very cool, Patty. All right. So again, that song I was talking about. Right there, track one on side two called Seasons. But again, the rest of this is really good. I love the first 4 or 5 Steve Miller albums. That's why I have them all. Love them. His later stuff, it's kind of good party music, but this early stuff was really kind of cool. Borderline psychedelic. All right, what do we got here? God, I'm gonna pull up my rotator cuff there. All right. I don't want Colton getting into the pints. All right, what do we got here? Number 3, these are in no order. This is the collective on the 4AD label. Ivo Watts, Russell, the founder of 4AD, he put this thing together called This Mortal Coil, and it was like a collective of 4AD artists coming and going and doing their thing. This is the second release, and this one's a double album, actually. 2-record set. So again, the 4AD, kind of gloomy looking. And I mean, I have both of the This Mortal Coil albums. I think they did another one in the early 90s. I don't have that one. I remember in an earlier video by Mike PC31, the Vinyl Policeman, he showed that third This Mortal Coil album, and I'd never even seen it before, but I do have the first two. So this is just, you know, get your thesaurus out and look. Gloom, dread, dark, brooding. You know, there I go. I'm just like, I'm Roger's thesaurus, right? So anyway, that's what this is like, but it really suits, you know, shitty November, because that November weather is a lot of those things. Kind of like the summer we just had, only colder. So with all the rain. And so anyway, if I was to recommend one of the songs on here, this is the best to me, a song called The Jeweler. There's a guy named Dominic Appleton. He was in another band called Breathless. I just pulled this out in context. This is a 4-song EP, but oddly, it was on the Bossa Nova label. So again, Dominic Appleton was the lead singer of this band, Breathless. Really good. That's a good EP if you want to look it up. Of course, in the UK. So that song, he sings the lead vocals on The Jeweler. It's really great. And there's an instrumental that goes into it. It's about 1.5 minutes called Velvet Belly. So I think if you look Velvet Belly into The Jeweler, if you look that up on YouTube, I don't think you would be disappointed if you like gothic and gloom, which is what we've got going on here. And again, you can see there the font, kind of cool font. This Mortal Coil, Filigree and Shadow, the name of that one. All right, and where are we going here? Clannad. So this is like Irish Celtic music. So lead vocalist, Mare Brennan right there, is the older sister of Enya. If you're the new age sounds of Enya, very popular in the 80s into the 90s. So this band had been around for a while. Like I said, this is their 8th studio release, and it's 1983 already at this point. So they've been active throughout the mid to late 70s. I mean, it's just kind of background music, but it fits this kind of season. Like, look at, you know, that thing there. It kind of looks like Stonehenge, but it's not. So anyway, that's Clannad. Most of the songs on this are in Gaelic. There's a really nice opener to this called Theme from Harry's Game. If you ever watched Under a Blood Red Sky, the U2 concert actually from Red Rocks, the venue I mentioned right there. Oh, nice tie-in there, Steve Harold. I've never been there, but I'd like to someday. But anyway, Theme from Harry's Game is playing in the background while they're interviewing some of the fans at the U2 show. So that always reminds me of that. And I think that's what first turned me on to Clint Ad. In fact, I know it is. And I was probably only about grade 11 at the time. But being a big U2 fan, it was just felt natural. And I dove in and bought this one. And I have one other one by Clint Ad. And I have a couple of Enya too. I'm not afraid to admit it. All right, and lastly, into the fall stuff. This kind of more ties into October. I showed that one too quick. This is Phantasmagoria. This is the Damned 7th studio release. The Damned, their 7th from 1985. Of course, it's called Phantasmagoria. Look at that goth queen on the cover there. So initially, what I wanted to say was, this is just the best of the Damned on compact disc, about 1979. I think they started around 76. During the punk explosion, of course, and they were one of the main bands, part of that, in London. So, you know, songs like Wait for the Blackout, New Rose, different band here. This is way more with kind of heading into Sisters of Mercy territory, kind of really gothic, different sound, but still really, really well produced compared to that early punk stuff. But this, and again, this is probably my favorite era, The Damned. This one, and what I played at the beginning right there, what was playing at the beginning of the video, rather, was this album. This was the follow-up right here to Phantasmagoria. There's Dave Vanian. If proof in the photo wasn't, or in the album cover isn't enough, he's a goth punk priest. Cool pop-up there, just like the pop-up books you had when you were a kid. Isn't that wild? Pretty cool, right? So that's Anything, and that was the title track I was playing at the beginning of the video there, in case you didn't catch on. Is there anything better than this? No. Hanging out with me on a Friday. So I bought this when it came out, like I said, the year 1986, and I don't know, I didn't keep the hype stickers back then. Wasn't a thing with me, but it was just on white vinyl, and this is a British import. I bought this at a store called Shake Records, long gone in Ottawa. When I was still in high school. Yeah, really great album. Street of Dreams, Shadow of Love, Sanctum Sanctorum. Jesus. And Grimly Fiendish was a big hit on this. Cool video for that one. But yeah, more November kind of fall theme stuff right there. So again, that's Sam St. John. He's got this thread going, show five albums that remind you of the fall or autumn. And Steve Harold, another shout out, and a big thank you to Steve for sending me that. Jane's Addiction, awesome, love it. And yeah, so no real appearance from Colton tonight, but we did have Patty as a special guest, very impromptu. I think she just hears me, and she just likes to peek in and say hello to all you folks out there in vinyl community, YouTube land. So anyway, I'll say a final salute. I send you a final salute. Cheers, and I'll see you next time.